Welcome to the series on Azure Migrate, your free migration and modernization platform, which helps you move workloads in a consistent and secure manner to Azure. In this video, we will show you how to assess your SQL Server resources for readiness to migrate and provide right-sized options in Azure. With Azure Migrate, you can discover and assess SQL Server instances and databases, standalone or highly available at scale. With the new Azure SQL assessment capability, you can understand readiness and blockers to migration, recommended target Azure service and right-sized SKU, as well as the reasoning behind the recommendation. You can also identify cost estimates of running your SQL Server deployments on Azure, as well as migration guidance, i.e. the steps you need to perform to be able to migrate using the recommended approach. Before you assess and effectively plan migration of Microsoft SQL Server deployments to Azure, you must ensure that all prerequisites for the successful discovery of SQL Server are met and all discovery issues are resolved. To learn more about the prerequisites, visit aka.ms/azuremigrate/sql-discovery, and to create minimum privilege credentials to discover SQL Server instances and databases, refer to aka.ms/azuremigrate/sql-discovery-script. Once discovery is successfully completed, you can navigate to the database's blade to initiate a SQL assessment. You can select the SQL servers that you want to assess and click on Create Assessment. While creating an assessment, you can specify properties for each target, such as target region for migration. You can also specify the environment type of source workload, that is dev test or prod, such that appropriate pricing can be applied. You can also select currency, offers such as pay-as-you-go, and savings options such as 1 or 3 year reservations, instance or Azure savings plan, and assessment criteria. You can also indicate if you want to bring your own Windows Server or SQL Server license to Azure with Azure Hybrid Benefit. By clicking on Edit Defaults, you can specify the target service tier and instance SKUs to indicate which Azure SQL offering you would like to leverage, or you can leave them to their default values to let Azure Migrate decide what is best for you. After specifying all the details, you can click on Review and Create Assessment. If all looks good, you can click on Create. The assessment is ready for review within a few minutes. You can see that we have assessed 92 servers, 188 instances, and 13,000 databases with 8 failover cluster instances and 21 availability groups. Further, we can see that several of our instances are either out of support or nearing end of support. Additionally, our discovery success is moderate, and we can identify what all we need to fix by clicking on View Issues. You can view the readiness for different migration approaches for SQL Server instances and databases, as well as the estimated cost for running those workloads in Azure. You can choose to dive deeper into reports targeted at respective SQL deployment targets in Azure, such as Azure SQL Managed Instance, or refer the summarized recommended report. The recommended report indicates the most efficient way of migrating your SQL Server deployments to Azure based on the selected migration preference. Azure Migrate considers both the migration readiness and the estimated cost, such that no SQL deployments are left behind, even those that haven't been discovered completely. In this case, it is recommending, based on our intent to modernize, that we replatform 126 SQL Server instances to PaaS and rehost 62 of them to IaaS. Going deeper, we see that the PaaS service being recommended is Azure SQL Managed Instance and IaaS service is Azure VM. Now, let's look at the details of the assessment for MS SQL Server on FC3 SQL 2K19FPL.com, which is a failover cluster instance and represents the data layer for an app that we're interested in modernizing. We can see that it is ready for migration to Azure SQL and SQL Server on Azure VM, and the recommended target is Azure SQL MI, given the intent to modernize specified earlier. The recommended configuration includes general purpose provisioned Gen 5, 4 vCores from a compute standpoint, and 32 gigabytes of storage. The entire configuration costs $215. Additionally, we can go deeper to view aggregated performance statistics such as allocated cores, CPU utilization, memory in use, etc. The Readiness tab helps understand the readiness for all SQL targets on Azure. We can see that we will have to address a few issues, but these are non-blocking changes for migration to Azure in general. In this case, if our application doesn't need Service Broker, we can disable the same to be ready for migration to Azure SQL DB or consider other targets. The Target Recommendations tab explains how the ideal target was determined. In this case, the SQL Server was ready for Azure SQL MI, whereas there were a few migration issues identified for Azure SQL DB. Additionally, the cost of running this instance on Azure SQL MI is estimated to be the lower among the two. The report also explains that it is simple to migrate to Azure SQL MI, as we just need to migrate all our user databases to the recommended managed instance configuration and do not have to set up a cluster of multiple nodes for high availability, which would have been the case if we were to migrate to SQL Server on Azure VM. We can see that the recommended tool for the job is Azure Data Studio. Azure Migrate's recommendations have got us covered, even when we don't have the right credentials or permissions to discover the SQL deployment accurately, so that we don't leave any SQL deployment behind. Now, let's explore directional reports for respective targets, especially the PaaS ones, since they are operationally cost-effective to run and maintain. Jumping to the Azure SQL MI Only Readiness Report, we can identify that 134 out of 186 instances are either ready or ready with conditions for migration to Azure SQL MI. We can see that MS SQL Server on HR SQL VM05 is marked as ready with conditions for Azure SQL MI, since one of the databases on it has file stream feature enabled. We can see that we have a workaround that we can adopt if we are interested in migrating this instance to Azure SQL MI. The recommended config for the same is Next-Gen General Purpose, provisioned Gen 5 SKU with 4 vCores and 96 GB of storage, which costs around $215. You can see that Azure Migrate provides two dedicated assessment reports for SQL Server on Azure VM. The one titled Instances to SQL Server on Azure VM covers the ideal approach for migrating each SQL Server deployment to a separate Azure VM with striped disks, such that there is no compromise with respect to performance. Let's look at MS SQL Server running on FC4, SQL 2K17.fpl.com, which is a disaster-resilient SQL Server deployment. Going deeper, we can view the performance statistics identified at source and understand the migration guidance. This instance wasn't discovered completely, since we didn't have the required permissions, but Azure Migrate was still able to provide a migration recommendation. In this case, we should copy the data from the active node to two SQL Server on Azure VM, such that the temp assets are moved into the temp drive of the VM and log and data assets are copied to respective storage pools. Once data is moved, I can set up a two-node cluster using Azure VM with shared disk as the witness. The other report, titled Servers to SQL Server on Azure VM, is targeted at a lift and shift or replication-based approach for migrating to Azure VM with least effort. You can leverage the Azure SQL DB Readiness Report to understand readiness, estimated cost, and SKU for migrating each successfully discovered database to Azure SQL DB. You can review the compute and storage cost distribution for migrating to Azure SQL MI or SQL Server on Azure VM or Azure SQL DB. At any moment, you can go to Settings and customize the assessment by changing selections for reserve capacity, migration strategy, Azure Hybrid Benefit, etc., to see how the cost varies, and choose the combination that works best. Additionally, you can export the assessment report for sharing or offline consumption. So this demo covers everything that we have in Azure Migrate to help you discover and assess your SQL Server instances and databases at scale. We've included Azure SQL Assessment Creation and its various options, Azure SQL Deployment Target and right-sized SKU recommendations, and associated reasoning and migration guidance, as well as cost details to make it easier for you to start prioritizing your data migrations with Azure Migrate. Once discovery and assessment are completed and you have built a high-confidence migration plan, you can leverage Azure Data Studio, Azure Database Migration Service, or Azure Migrate's native lift and shift capability to migrate your SQL Server deployments. With Azure Data Studio and Azure Database Migration Service, you can migrate your databases and server objects to Azure SQL MI, SQL Server on Azure VM, or Azure SQL DB. With Azure Migrate's server migration capability, you can lift and shift your servers to Azure virtual machines. You can even perform a test migration without impacting our production workloads before the actual migration. Thank you for watching this video.